The following video will focus on niche modeling as well as the Carica papaya species as a whole. However, to get started, I will firstly discuss what niche modeling is. What is niche modeling? Niche modeling looks at species distribution. It is also used in environmental management and covers habitat suitability, environmental change impact, and helps by managing endangered species. In this video, the species that we will be mainly focusing on is the Carica papaya. The Carica papaya is commonly known as papa or papaya. This fruit is part of the Caricaceae family, which is a small family species of flowering plants. The fruit is also known to be rich in vitamin A and C and has a great medicinal value. The papaya is mostly cultivated in warmer tropical areas and are native to Central America as well as Mexico. In South Africa, papaya is mostly cultivated in Mpumalanga. 61% is produced here, 37% in Limpopo and 2% in KwaZulu-Natal. As the papaya is mostly cultivated in warmer tropical areas, we see that in these warmer areas, they mature in the time of 6 to 9 months. However, in cold temperatures, they take up to 9 to 11 months to mature. The papaya fruit grows best in soil that has a neutral pH balance, and from February to March is considered to be the best time to plant. It produces a yield of 75 to 100 tons of hectare per year, and its lifespan is up to 3 to 4 years. The plant is originally found in Central America and Mexico. However, India and Hawaii are currently the largest producers of papaya. Cold climates are not effective growth condition for the fruit. Other factors that may affect distribution is water availability, temperature, and type of soil. The papaya is known to thrive more in tropical conditions. The following figure 1.1, displays the largest producer of papayas in the world. Although Hawaii is not displayed here, it is known that they produce 95% of papayas on their small island. As mentioned before, papayas thrive more in tropical conditions. Therefore, if we look at figure 1.2, we can see that distribution of the species are mainly close to the equator. This is due to the fact that warmer conditions are situated here. As a result, we are left with a tropical distribution belt. In order to see global distribution of papaya, I had to make use of DivaGIS. DivaGIS is a free computer program that is used for mapping geographical data as well as analyzing biodiversity data. I also used the Global Biodiversity Information Facility, shortly known for GBIF. This is a research infrastructure that holds large amount of biodiversity information. So by using DIVA and the data of GBIF, I was able to observe species distribution, specifically of the Carica papaya. Current distribution focuses on areas where climates are suitable for growth. In this figure, it represents its current climate distribution, specifically for papaya. By referring to the legend on the left of the map, we are able to see which areas have the most suitable climate. If we look closely, parts of North America, South America, Africa, and Asia, specifically the islands, have suitable climatic conditions. In this figure 2.1, represents the future climatic distribution. Just like the previous map, we can refer to the left in order to compare suitable climatic conditions. However, if we compare current and future climatic distribution, we can see that some areas have lost their suitability, and this can be due to various influences. Ecocrop represents areas that are the most suitable for a crop to grow. In this case, figure 3 represents the current ecocrop suitability for papaya. By referring to the legend on the map, it is easy to see where suitability lies. Again, we can see that most areas in South America, parts of North America, Africa, and the islands of Asia are the most suitable. Figure 3.1 represents the future suitability of eco-crop. If we compare current and future crop, we can see that certain areas have lost their suitabilities, such as the North America. I will now focus more on the distribution of papayas in South Africa. Papaya distribution is poor in South Africa. This is due to the unfavorable climatic conditions. South African markets are small, however, they are still lucrative. Many of our papayas are imported. This is also due to the unfavorable conditions. Figure 4 represents the current climate distribution of Southern Africa. If we refer to our legend on the left, we can see that we have poor suitability, specifically climate suitability for papayas. Figure 4.1 represents future climatic distribution in Southern Africa. If we look and compare future and current climatic distribution, we can see that climate distribution has improved in South Africa. However, it is still very poor. What does this mean for South Africa? When comparing the climatic data of future and current in South Africa, we can see a slight improvement. However, it is still poor climatic suitability. We are also faced with limitations such as soil type and agricultural space. The opportunities that lie ahead are more yield production as the climate suitability improves. This means there will be less dependency on import and that South Africa will experience higher temperatures. We will also be faced with threats such as droughts. This is due to past experience in South Africa. And as our climate is not extremely suitable, we are faced with a crop attracting any type of diseases. Thank you for listening, and I would like to apologize for any alternative noises in the background. Thank you very much.